Hi everyone, in this class we are going to talk about branching strategy in GitHub. Okay, branching in GitHub. So what is the need of branch? So what is branch here? Okay, what is a branch and what is the need of branching and why do we need to create a branch? That we are going to discuss in today's class. Okay. So if you go to GitHub, suppose in previous classes, we have created a repository. You know how to create a repository. So here you can able to see branch. So now, what is the branch name here? So we have a master branch, and we are pushing all the code into master branch. We have only one branch here. If you observe here, okay, here you can see only one branch. But in real time, if you go with any organization, so we should not push directly into master branch. So there is a branching strategy. Okay, there is a branching strategy. So there we have multiple branches. Okay, we have multiple branches like dev, suppose dev, QA, and prod. Okay, so these are the regions as well as branches also. So if you want to push our code into dev region, so again here we need to create our future branches. So here we are going to call it as future, and here we are going to call it as release branch under QA. So under dev, again, we are going to create user story branch. Okay, user stories branch. I'll tell you one by one. Okay, so this for here we are going to create a user story branches. Okay, like this, you can create number of branches with one repository. Okay, one repository. Just I will show you. So what is the need of branching? First, suppose in your team there are three members are there. You both are working in a same project. And you can assume this is a, as of now, okay, this is a code repo. This is a code repository for master. So you three are working in a same module or same project. So you want to push your code into, okay, you want to push your code into code repo. Okay, suppose the person A has completed his code. Okay, so what he will do, he will push the code into Git repo here. At the same time, suppose the person 3 also completed the code. Okay, so he is also trying to push the code into the same repository. So this time what will happen is, okay, you know, the code conflicts, okay, the merge conflicts will occur. Merge conflicts will occur. So we'll talk about later. Okay, what is merge conflicts and all. So just as of now, you can remember this point. Okay, so why merge conflicts will occur means, okay, you have already cloned and push your latest update. Okay, once you updated your code, okay, so the person B or C is trying to push the code. Okay, it's like another code. So before going to update or before going to commit, what you need to do? You need to pull this code, and you have to, again, you have to make a changes and you have to update it. Otherwise, code conflicts will occur. Okay, this time also, this person also trying to push this code. So here only the first person only can able to push code into successful. Okay, successful. So here these guys will get error, unable to push the codes, or else what we can keep it as like code conflicts. Okay, code conflicts will occur. Code conflicts will occur. So that is the reason. Okay, this is one reason. Okay, this is one reason. This is one reason. The another reason is there are again person A, person B, person C is working in the same project, but different modules. Okay, different modules. Suppose we are working as a payment module, he is working in a transactions module, he is working in a summary module. So you want to okay, you can assume, so you want to merge your code into code repo. So this time we cannot see, the only first person can able to do the transactions, okay, like okay, the commit operations he can perform. So the rest two, you will get some error also. So here we are unable to push the code. Okay, you are unable to merge the code. The three persons have separated code. Okay, separate files, individual files. So you can assume like this. Okay, so you created arithmetic. Okay, we have created arithmetic program, and there is another person. He has created a car.java. Okay, there is another person. He created first.java. So these three are in different systems. You want to merge it into the single repository. So this time, the only first person can able to update the code. The another persons and all, okay, what they need to do? So they need to again pull it, and they have to do some code. They have to remove and they have to add it. So in that case, so the branching will help us here. So how the branching will happen? Okay, just observe here. Just see. So we have a master branch. Suppose we have a master branch here. We have a master branch. So in top of master branch, okay, first I will keep it here. Okay, in top of master branch. So what we are trying to do is, we will try to create a develop branch. Okay, first we'll create a develop branch here. Okay, we'll create a develop branch. I'll keep it like this. So first we have master branch. From master branch we are going to create a, okay, I'll keep the arrows like this so that you will get understand. Okay, we need to create a develop branch. From develop branch, this person A, what he is going to do? So he is going to create his own branch, like, okay, user story for, suppose if it is a sprint, okay, we'll talk about later the sprints and all, okay, user story. So whatever the program, suppose you are going to touch it as hello, or okay, let's keep it into sprint one. Okay, he is going to create a, or else his name also, user story A. He is going to create a separate branch here. I'll tell you what is the use of this. Then what person B will do? So he will also create another branch on top of this branch, develop branch only. Okay, okay So now person C, okay, person A, person B, okay. It's like individual branches. Here's a story A, here's a story B. See, we will see everything, it's in a practical mode, okay. Don't worry about that. First, he will also try to create the branch on top of develop. So, where it went? Okay, you can assume like this. So, we have a master branch here. From master branch, we have created a develop branch. So, this is for dev region. Okay, you want to push your code into first dev region and you have to deploy into development region. Then person A, what the person A will do, he will check out the code or clone the code, okay. I'll create like this, okay. Create new branch on top of develop. This guy also same. So now we have three individual branches. What this person will do, this person, person A, person B, and person C. So they will develop, okay. They will take the code from user story A for this A person, okay. This guy will take the code from user story B. This guy will take the code from user story C. So we know already how to clone the code, okay. But here it is the branching strategy, okay. Master, on top of this master, we have a develop. In develop, we are going to create a user story branch, user story branches here. Okay, so again, see, you can create many, guys, okay. You can create many. So on top of develop, so you can create one more, okay, future branch. Future, okay, on top of develop, we are going to create it for future. Okay. Let it be like this. And again, one more thing. Get branch on top of now. Not develop. Now we can, it will be like, okay, future branch. And future. Of future. So how this branch is created? On top of future is created on top of develop and develop. Develop. Okay, just observe here. So we have a master branch. So we have a master branch here. Okay, this is my master branch. So we have already created. Now on top of master branch, see, the in real time, again, in real time, this master branch and develop branch and future branch, it's already created by your technical lead or your manager. But this is for our testing purpose, or we are doing a POC in our local, okay. So you want to know and you have to follow, okay, how the branching strategy. We need to create it, how to create a branch, okay. That is very simple only. I'll show you. There are two ways we can create. One is by using git bash also we can create, or else we can create directly from here itself. That's very simple. But try to understand the concept. but try to understand the concept. So first master is there, then develop, then future. From future, so individual developers, they are going to create a user story branches and they will work on the code and what they will do. Okay. So this is one phase. Okay. This is one phase. This is about like, okay, clone, create branch and clone. Okay. Create branch and clone. Create branch and clone. Next. So once you develop the code and you have to push, right? Okay. So after pushing, so what will happen? Okay. After push your code into user story branch. So how it is going to move into develop, we will see now. Okay. So first thing again, so there were three developers. Okay. Three or more. Okay. For the example, we have taken, there are only three developers. If you want to push the same project code into repository. So for the only the first person can able to successfully push the code into the repository. Also the maintainability also it's a very less here. Okay. Also we will get code conflicts and merge conflicts because we don't know at what time you are going to push and this guy also going to push and this guy also going to push. So that's why the branching strategy came here. So first anyway the master is there always. Now develop branch is there. From develop, we are going to create a feature. Okay, we are going to create a feature. From feature, individual developer, they will create a user story branches. Okay, that's why the arrow mark you can see, guys. Okay, the arrow mark you can see. See, we are going to create it. Okay, this guy will clone. Okay. Clone the project first, okay, before going to start. This guy will clone. See the arrow marks, okay? This guy will clone it, okay? Then, after cloning, the persons can work individually, their work, okay? Individually, they will work, okay, different modules. Then we will see how to push the code, how to push the code, push code push code push or commit. Okay, I'll keep it as like this. So here what will happen? Okay, let me remove. So you have developed the code. Okay, fine. We'll keep it like this. Okay, just observe. You have completed the module. Okay, there is a module like, okay, suppose you have written the arithmetic module. So now what you want to do, you want to push your code into. So we are not going to push our code directly into master, okay? You have to push your code into user story, okay? What you will do, you will push or commit, okay? I'll keep it like this, okay? Commit and push or else that will be better. Commit and push, okay? Commit and push. The person B also completed. Okay, first we will talk about this guy. The person A is completed, commit and push. Now, just observe here. Now, you will take care of committing the code into user story branch here by using git bash. By using git bash or STS, you can directly push your code. So here, how to then you need to push your code into future branch. Future branch. So here, how you are going to do is, okay, you need to raise a pull request. Okay, keep in mind. So this is very important. Pull request. So what is pull request? Okay, we'll see. We'll call it as PR or pull request. So whenever you are going to raise a pull request, I will show you. So first, just like just a theory class, okay, just observe. Pull request is like, so you are sending the code review, okay? You are sending your code into the review, code review for code review with your technical lead or your lead, okay? Technical lead or your lead. See, you know whatever the code you have written, so that is correct. But you have to review with your technical lead or someone. You have to raise a pull request. So what they will do, they will approve or reject. So if it is approved, automatically it will deploy into the, it will deploy into the future, or it will commit into the future branch. Okay, so now, so whatever the code you have written, that is correct, and you raise a pull request, your manager or team lead, it is approved. Now successfully pushed your code into future branch. Okay, fine. The same way, the person B also completed his code. What he will do? He will do commit and push into user story branch. So once it is done, he has to raise a PR or pull request. Okay, pull request. Or pull request for which branch? Future branch. So that is very important. So once it is approved or rejected, okay. So most of the times, so reject means, okay, approve. They will approve. So reject means, so there are some changes needs to be done or some loggers needs to be added. So in that case, they will do reject. Or they will give some comments also, okay. What are the changes you have to do? So that is about pull request. We will see that. Now, this guy also completed. The person C also completed his code. And what you are going to do? You are going to push your code into user story branch C. Now, he has to raise a pull request. So after raising pull request, the code will get merged into future branch. Now, all the three modules is present in a future branch. All the three modules are present in a future branch. Okay. So future branch, it was there. Now, fine. Now, just observe. Again, so when you want to deploy from feature to develop, so again we have a PR only. See, from here only, so the very first step only you will use STS or git bash to push your code into user story branches. From user story to feature or feature to develop, okay, feature to develop, you will raise PRs only. You will raise PR. PR is nothing but pull request. So the same way we have development region, we'll talk, okay. We have a QA region. We have a production region, something like this. For every region, you can create different branches over here. So that is depends on how your organization is going to follow the structure. From develop to QA, you will push your code. I mean, again, you will raise the PR once the development is done. Next, from QA to prod. Here, what we are doing, we are raising just PRs only, okay? PR. But here, you don't have any access from QA to production, okay? There is a DevOps team they are going to take care. Okay, they have to approve DevOps team. DevOps or support teams need to approve pipelines. Okay. Pipelines or pull request. Okay. These things. Okay. This is just structure. Just keep it in your mind. Okay. How the process is going to follow. So again, I'm going to explain. Suppose. So here I didn't write anything, right? Okay. So if you want, you can keep one QA. But here, nothing is happening here. Okay, just branches we have created. That's it. Branches we have created. So the empty branch, the empty repository they have created with the master branch. Then we are going to create a develop. Then we have created on top of feature branch. Then user story A, user story B, and user story C. And they will clone the project and they will work on it. Next process, the same diagram. It's like the arrow marks are different. Okay. The commit and push, the person A, okay, is going to deploy into user story A. And again, we need to raise a pull request. The same way it will happen for these three persons. From future to again, you need to raise a pull request. Now it will go to the development region. So once it is deployed and unit tested, then it will go to QA region. QA is nothing but it's like a quality assurance. So here only the testing will happen. So whatever you develop the code, you are going to push it into QA region. So here the testers will perform the testing and UAT also there. Okay. Next, production region. So it's like a live. Okay. Prod is like, okay. Prod is nothing but a live. We are going to deploy it. So here there are different teams who are involved. Okay. They are going to take care of this. But As a developer, you have to take care up to development region at least. Okay, there are some senior developers, they are going to take care for QA and even production deployments also. Okay, fine. Now we will see. I'll create another project. Okay. We'll create one new project so that you will get understand. Okay, create new project for banking. Suppose for banking. So first, the very first step, guys. Okay, you have to observe. Create a code repo. So how to create this? Just go to your repository. Here we have an option in the repositories, create new. Just I will keep it as like, okay. Banking project. Okay. So it's my banking project. Okay. That's it. Okay. I'm not going to do anything. Just observe. So this is my project. So if you see here, this is an empty one. There are no branches, nothing. Okay. So by default, it will be a master branch. By default, it will be a master branch. Okay, fine. Next, what I will do, just I will check out that code or clone that one. Go to your repository, click on, give right click, git clone your project name. Just observe. Git. Now, if you see here, see banking and project was banking and project. Banking and project. Banking and project. So now I'll take any. Okay. So this is one way of doing it. So now just take any sample code for any project. Okay. Just I will copy paste. Or else I will go to STS. Okay. STS directly. See, this is not Java project. So if it is a Java project, if it is a Java project, directly we can import it. But here the problem is, so it is not a Java project. It's like empty repository they have created for us. Okay, fine. Empty repository. Just I will take any previous codes. Okay, previous kind of things. Banking project. See, as of now, I'm not going to clone into my STS also, just observe. So I'll create an empty one. Click on your project name. Just let me push that code. Git status. Okay, git status is done. Git add, it will add all the files. Again, git status. Git commit minus m. Initial commit. Git push minus u. Origin. Okay, so this is how we can create an initial project. And so if you observe here, okay, main or master. So now let me change it here also. Okay, master, right? Okay, I'll keep it as main. It's main. See here, now it is main, so we don't have any branches. So now the first step from main to what you need to do, you have to create a develop branch. You have to create a develop branch. So here we have a branch options. Okay, see, from git bash also you can create it. Otherwise you can go to directly this one, your code repository. Here you can see branch here. So okay, first I will create it from GUI. Okay, click on new branch. So what is the branch you need to create? Next, from main to develop, right? So what is the source? So here, just observe here, develop is main, correct? Create new. Now one branch is done again. So if you go to here and you can verify, see, main also there and develop also it is there. But anyway, we are not going to touch anything with the main. Okay, and develop also the branching strategy will follow. Okay, from develop to what we need to create? Future. So what is future? You may get a doubt. Okay, see, in your project there are 1 to 6 releases. Okay, 1 to 6 releases means, okay, you are going to deploy your project within a year in a 6 times. Okay, you are going to develop some modules and you are going to deploy it into production. After some time, there is a release to you are going to deploy. So how Facebook, sorry, okay, not only Facebook. So how it is the WhatsApp? So earlier, earlier you can see there is no WhatsApp status. So that is like version one. So after that, they have added some status. So that is version two. Now there is a new feature like, okay, you can follow some people or so something. Okay, it's like that. Okay, so whenever you are going to develop any project or any app, okay, there are some releases. So now you can assume this is a future one. Future one. Okay, we'll create future one here. So how to create feature? How to create a feature? Again, go to branches, click on new branch, click on new branch. Okay, so here you can type feature one, feature one. From where we need to take that one? Develop. So this is very important. So what is the source? So the source you have to select. Okay, create new branch. So if you go to again code, if you go to again code, see, main is there, develop is there, feature one also there. So this strategy, these things again, okay, up to this part, who will take care? Either senior developers or technical leads, they are going to take care. You no need to worry. From here, where you need to pick your code, okay? From this part, you have to concentrate, okay? Suppose you are going to work on some module. So what you need to do, again, guys, okay? Again, from feature one to user story one, you need to take it, okay? Just observe. So how to create a branch? Go to branches here. New branch. User story one. User story one. Or user story A, whatever it is. From where? So always you need to pick it from future one. So like that, how many branches you need to create it? There are three branches, user story B and user story 3. I'll create user story B and I'll show you from this one how to create a user story C. User story B. From where we need to pick, okay, what is the source? So that is from feature one. Okay. Now if you go to code, if you see the branches here, see, now the branches are created. Now the branches are created. So again, I'm going to close all the tabs here. All the tabs here. All the tabs here. Again, if you go to workspace, I'll remove the banking project also. See, I have removed everything now. I have removed everything now. Just observe. So you are a person A. You are a person A. You have to work with this branch, user story A branch. So what you need to do, click on this user story A, go to this code, go to this code. Okay. Copy this one. Just copy this one. Now, directly you can go to STS. Okay, there are two ways you can pull your code, you can clone your code. Okay, the first way I'll show you from git bash. I will show you. Okay, give right click here, show more options, git bash here. Just observe. See, there is no banking project here. And there is no banking project here also. So first you need to clone it. Git. See, again, the same options only. But the thing is, you have to remember creating the branches. From where to where you need to take it up your code. Okay, main and develop and feature one. Up to this one. From feature one, user story A and user story B and user story C, D, C, something like that. We are going to create it and we are going to push it into feature one. So that is our main mode. Okay, just observe. Git clone. Paste it here. See, we have multiple branches. from which branch you need to take your code, so that you have to mention here. Be careful, be careful. Minus B, B means branch, hyphen B, okay, or else minus B, you just to re hyphen A. So this is your branch. From here you need to clone your code, okay. Observe here. So as soon as we have cloned, so now we can see the code also. See, this is a sample project. We have cloned it from repository. The clone is done. So next step, what you need to do, you can go to STS and you can go to import, click on general, click on existing projects, go to next, click on the browser, click on this browser, go to workspace, select your project. My project is banking project, correct? My project is banking project. Done. Banking project is done. Just finish it. See here. See the sample project they have given this one. Okay. The sample project they have given this one. I have cloned it. Okay. I have cloned it. And I have imported via STS also. Now here I am going to add my module as, suppose, transaction module. Transaction module. Public static void main. You are going to write something. Suppose you have completed your task. So you have written the program, okay. This is my trans module. And it's completed also, okay. And it's completed. Okay, whatever the work they have assigned with you. So you have completed and you are going to push your code again. Okay, again. So what you need to do? So if you observe here, see Java workspace one only. So for clone only, you have to do like this. So just to minimize this one. Now we can go to your project. Now we can go to your project. Give right click here. So this is like, okay, the person A, what he is doing. Okay, I'll tell you for person B, how he is going to import via STS. So that it will cover the two test cases, the two use cases. Okay. Now he has modified the code. Okay. So now you need to push it. So as soon as if you give right click and if you observe this one, see here you can able to see the branch. The previous one, there is no project and branch also while cloning. So this is the difference, guys. This is the difference. So while clone, what we will do? So there is a empty space. In that empty space, you will give the right click and you will go to git bash for cloning. Again, if there is a branch, git clone url hyphen b branch name, you have to provide like this, then only it will clone, because we have a branches here, we have a branches. Okay, this is very, very important. So how to clone if there is a branch? Git clone project URL. So that's why I'll keep it like this. Then hyphen B and branch name. So this is the first step done. First step is done and you have imported the code and you have modified it. Okay. So you are thinking you have to push your code using git bash. Now you right click here, go to show more options, click on git bash. Just observe here. So here you can able to see user story A also. Okay. See git status. So this is the new file you have added. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to add my all the changes. So there is a comma. Okay. So that's why it is giving an error. So you have to type dot git add dot git add dot. Okay. So if you want to see the status, you can see now also git status, git commit minus m. You will write a comment like, okay, transaction module changes, transaction module changes, git commit. Okay, the commit is happened, fine. Now git push minus u origin. See, you have to provide the branch name here. That is very careful. Now, what is our branch? User story, a branch. So, see the normal way only. Git add, git status, git commit, and git push. So, instead of master or main, our branch name will come. Okay, now we can go to your branch. Okay, your branch, and here you can see what are the changes it has happened. See, transaction module changes were happened just now. So this is the only file the user is added. Okay, the user is added. So this way we can assume the user story. Okay, this way we can see. So what are the changes we have added via user story A branch? User story A branch. So now, just okay, one step is done. You are an user, you push your code into user story branch. Next, what is that? You have to raise a pull request from where to where? From user story to future. So how to raise pull request? Just observe here. See, as soon as if you push your code, you can able to see here, compare a pull request. So this is one option. Otherwise, what you can do here. So we have an option like pull request option. So here you can go. Okay. Click on this pull request tab. Click on new pull request or compare and pull request. Both are same only. Okay. So see here from base. What is the base branch? So base is from user story A to. So you are the user, right? You are the user A. Okay. From A to where you are pushing. So we are pushing it via, you are pushing the code into future one. Just observe. So this way we can raise a compare and pull request. Okay, so we didn't try so far. Okay, what I will do is I'll go to pull request, click on new pull request. So if you want to compare with any branches, you can do a comparison. Okay, so this is a base branch. Okay, comparison branch is this one. Okay, so it's like vice versa. So always, so you see normally, so if you need to see the arrow markers. Okay, from a to future one. So if you observe this one, from user story to future. Okay, this is a future one, right? Future one. See, raising the PRs are very simple. you can go to pull request and you need to select the branches here. Okay, you need to select the proper branches here. So here I'm selecting from future. Okay, future is correct only. From where to where? User story A to future one. See, sometimes if you are using Bitbucket or some other repositories, okay, some other code repo tools, okay, so that time, so it will be an vice versa from user story to future, something like this. Okay, if it is a GitHub, okay, it will be going from user story A to feature. Okay, see, both are same only, but options are different. So don't get confused. So always you have to remember from where to where you are doing. What is the base branch and what is the comparison branch? Okay. Now create pull request. Create pull request. So here you can add transaction module changes. Okay, just you can add the description. So what are the changes and what you are doing? So here you need to create a pull request, right? You need to create a pull request. So before going to create a pull request, so here, if you are working in an organization, if you are working in any organization, so here it will show you, the reviewers names. Okay, reviewers names. Suppose I am going to type VA Tech Talks. Suppose. So this name is not present in this GitHub. So that is the reason it is not showing. So suppose if you are working in XYZ office, okay. So here you can able to see your project manager name or your team lead. Okay, there are some review person names. Okay, who is going to review your code? Here you can able to see it and you can assign the pull request with the corresponding person. So that is the reason. So here no one is there for reviewers. So what we are doing, assign it with via yourself only. Okay, just I will click on assign yourself. Okay, assign yourself and create pull request. See, now it is in open state. So as soon as if you create a pull request, right, the corresponding person can, okay, he will get a mail trigger and he can able to see this committed transactions, the committed code also. See now we are able to see the commits because you have assigned the PR with yourself or myself. I have assigned the PR with myself only. Okay, so I don't have access to assign the PR with some other persons. So what I will do, okay, you can assume, suppose you are the reviewer, so you are going to review my code. So after reviewing the changes, see, review changes. So reviews are good. Suppose if the reviews are good, if the code is good, if there are no comments, okay, so they will write some codes here. Okay, the code is reviewed. Okay, the code is reviewed and you can commit your code into next branch. Okay, comment and submit review, something like this. Suppose there are some mistakes in the code. Okay, here we are going to write, okay, add the loggers for the project, something like this we will write and we will comment out, submit review, something. Okay, so now if the code and everything is good, so what the review person will do, the reviewer will merge your code. See, merge pull request again. So here you can create a merge request. So from merge, what will happen? It will merge the code. Once everything is done perfectly for the pull request, whatever the code it is available in user story A, it will come to future one. Okay, future one. Add a comment and close the pull request. Okay, close pull request. This is closed now. Okay, files are changed. So now we can go to, now we can go to future branch. Now we can go to future branch. See, the branch is up to date with the main. Okay. And what are the commits? So here you can see the history. Here you can see the history. So here we have only initial commit only. It has happened. So still we can see pull request. So we have raised a pull request, but the merge is not happened. The merge is not happened. Why merge is not happened? Let's see. The base branch is whichever one. Compared branches user story A. So able to match your code. Create pull request, transaction module changes, create pull request. Checking for ability to code, okay. The branch has no conflicts in the base branch. In the base branch. Now, what you can do? So here we have an options. Rebase and merge, okay. The one commit from base branch will be rebased and added to the base branch, okay. That's fine. Or else you can create a merge only. You can create a merge only. Okay, merge request. So confirm merge. Confirm merge. See, after reviewing your code, your senior lead or your manager or someone. So just, so your duty is like, okay, just to see, to push your code into user story branch and raising the PR, up to raising the PR. So this is your work. So who will do your, it's okay, who will approve your code? So your lead or technical lead or manager, he will review your code and he will merge the code into future one. Okay, future one. But here, everything is we only. Okay, we are doing everything. Okay, but this is the concept you have to remember. This is the concept. So to pull request, you have to take care. So wherever you are raising the pull request, you have to take care in that case. So the reviewer is different person. What he will do, he will review it and he will merge the code. Okay. So I have reviewed this code. Okay. Everything is good in my commits. Okay. In your commits, whatever it is. What happened? I came to back right. Okay. Again. Click on merge. Confirm merge. Okay. I'll open before another branch. Just observe. You have pushed the code into future branch. That is fine. Okay. Sorry. You have pushed the code into user story A branch. So here you can see 13 minutes ago. But if you observe future branch, you have raised only PR. You have raised only pull request. So we will take care, your technical lead is going to take care for reviewing your code and he is going to approve and merge. So that is the reason still we are not able to see the new modules in under source folder. Okay. Now I am going to review it and I am going to merge this one. See, confirm merge. Just observe. See, confirm merge. So merge is successfully done. Just come here just to refresh. See, transaction module is added. Okay. Transaction module is added. So this is how the person A is going to work, the real time work he will do. Okay, so now so far we have seen by using git bash, right? Okay, so now we are going to see how to check out the code. Okay, how to check out the code or check in the code by using STS directly. Okay, just observe here. Okay, let me change the branch also. I'll switch on to another workspace so that you won't get any confused. I'll create a new workspace here inside the Java. So that means the person B. Okay, new workspace. Workspace 2. Okay, now workspace 2. So this is my another workspace. The person B is going to use this. See, the person A task is completed. He puts the code into user story A and he raises a pull request. The pull request also approved and it is merged with the future branch. Okay, future branch. So again, the same way we can raise the pull PRs. Okay, the higher management. Okay, they are going to take care to raise the pull request and they are going to approve it for different reasons. But here, the person B also, the same thing only, he is going to do it, but I am going to show you without using git bash, so that you will get to know how we are going to check in and check out the code. Okay, check in and check out the code. See, you can assume I am the person B. Now I am going to import. Okay, here directly we have an option, import. Click on git option, click on projects from git, clone URI. See, this is very simple, right? So instead of that one, so this is very simple, but that is totally depends on you, what is the option you are going to use it. Okay, now I want to check out my code. See, again, now the person B, right? Okay, person B or person C. Okay, now the person C. Okay, you can think about this person C. So what he will do, he is going to create a branch on top of future one, always. Okay, future one, user story C. Just see, user story C is available here. No, user story C is not available. What I am going to do here, just I will go to branches. I'll create new branch. See, this can be anything, guys. Okay, this you want, you can keep it as your name also. Suppose Chandana. So you can also keep it as Chandana. Okay, that's also fine. But here, as per the industry standards, so whatever the organization they are going to follow, so that you can follow. Okay, so if they are going to create user story, you can create it. Suppose if there is a bug fix, okay, if there is a bug fix in that module, okay, see, the person A is created on project, created some code, and he pushed into feature branch, and the person C needs to work on the same code. What he is going to do, or he want to add some modules, he need to take the code from future. We need to take the code from future branch, correct? See, there is no interrelation between A, B, C. So there is a relationship between feature only, right? Okay. So always you can create the branch from C, user story C. Okay. Or bug fix from source. From which source? Feature one. From feature one. Create new branch. Just observe. Create new branch. I have created a new branch here. Go to code. So here you can see user C also created. See, you have created on top of feature one, right? Feature one. So that is the reason you can able to see the what is the code it is available in feature branch. See, the feature branch available, it is in transaction also. Okay, that's fine. We will take that code. Okay, we'll take the always latest code. We'll take always latest code only. So what is my branch? User story C. Okay, go to code. Click on this URL. Okay, click on this URL. So how to clone the project from STS? Again, I'll show you. This is another person. You can assume like, okay, import Git projects from Git. Click on next. Clone URI, next. So here you have to give your username, sorry, URI name. You have to give your URI name. You have to give your username and password. Okay. So sometimes it will ask, it may not ask. Okay. Just click on next. We'll see. So it is not asking. See. So here, the beauty is it will show you all the branches here. So which branch you want to check in? Suppose if it is a Git bash, what we are doing? We are doing Git space clone and URL name and branch name. So that is differently. It's like a command based. Okay. Command based. So here it is a graphical user. Right, okay, just like a GUI. Okay, I want to check out or clone the project from, you can click on deselect, click on user story C. Okay, done. So where you want to place your directory? Okay, I'll select. So we have created already workspace here. It's in a E folder inside the Java workspace 2. Okay, workspace 2. Okay, click on next. Next, finish. Click on finish. So it's loading. Just to refresh here. What happened? See, if you are using Git bash again, you have to clone it into your workspace. Then you have to import your code. See, banking project. This is done. Workspace 2. So workspace 2 is the banking project. So it is already. It's already imported. Then why it is not showing here? Okay, that's fine. So once it is imported, see, normally, so once it is imported, so no need to export. I think I might miss some options. Let me delete from workspace to Java. Workspace 2, correct? I'll delete this. Okay, folder in use. So somewhere it is using, and I think this one only. Let's switch into workspace. So let me reload. Okay, this is the workspace. Okay, this is a, another person. Okay, that's fine. The workspace too. Just reload. See, there is a, not required to give any commands. If you want to clone, you can directly give the URL and you can select the branch name and you can clone it. You can clone it. Okay. What is the option? Okay, again I will see whether we can able to clone it or not. So it's a banking project, yes, correct. Correct. So it will show you the all the options here. Fetch a commit, also fetch tag. Okay, fine. My workspace is this one. Where is my workspace? Inside the Java workspace 2. Okay, it's already there. Okay, just to see clone submodules. We don't have any submodules here. Close newly imported projects upon completion. Okay, search for nested projects. Delete the configuration project manager. Add the projects into work sets. Okay. Or else. Okay, fine. So now see here. The project is imported successfully. Correct. Now the project is imported successfully. But my project name is different. Why it is coming as Java Basics? There is one folder, it is mismatched. Okay, let me close this once again. I'll delete from beginning. Just deleted. That's done. Okay. Click on STS. Java workspace 2, okay. Go to file and click on import projects from Git, clone URI, this is an URI. So what is the branch? User story C branch. Here I need to keep, I want to keep my files into my workspace, Java workspace 2. So this is a person C workspace. Okay, this is a person C workspace. See, it is saving inside the banking project, again inside the banking project. Okay, where it is, let me take it. Instead of going to pull it for multiple times. Projects from Git, clone URI. Okay. Project, banking project. Okay, fine. So here I have imported my project from directly from GitHub. See, I'm not using any commands over here. Just observe. So here I need to create a module. Okay, there is a separate module. It's like payments. This is my module, payments module. So I have created my payments module. See, again, I'm telling you, so there are two ways. One is using GitBash. So that is, if you want, you can use. I'm telling the two ways for you. That is totally depends on you. So either you want to use it, GitBash, you can use GitBash. Either you want to use this one, you can use this one. Okay. This is my payments module. Okay, done. So after it is done, so what you can do, you can go to your project directly. Go to team, click on commit. So here you can see what are the files you have modified. Okay, what are the files you have modified and you have newly added here. Just click on this two plus buttons, write the message. Payments module code added. Click on commit and push. So here it will ask you the username and password. See here, always I told you, right, you have to remember the token key. So if it is a Git bash, so one time the username and password you have to give, otherwise you have to give always the token name. Just click on login. Okay, see, now successfully pushed your code into user story c branch. So if you go to C branch, yes, okay, this is a C branch. See, just now, we have added payments module. Here you can see now, okay? Just now we have added one file here. So after adding, so what is the responsibility? What are the responsibilities for employee C or user C? He need to create a pull request for future one. Just create a pull request. Okay. So what is the branch? You have to select. See, this is a branch. Base is future. From user C. Payment module added. Okay. The same thing, you can copy paste it here. Okay. If you want, you can add the reviewers. Okay, here we don't have any reviewers. Okay, assign with yourself and create a pull request. After creating pull request, so the notification will send to your technical lead. He will go to this pull request and he will see what are the changes you have done. Okay, if you open this one, he can able to see what are the changes you have made it. Okay. And he is going to review and merge the peer, merge pull request. Okay, confirm merge. See, now you can directly go to future branch and open the. Okay, go to history, future branch history. See, the person A is push the code into transaction module. Okay, he created separate branch and he pushed the code into future. And this is for user C. So both the codes, we can see it in a future now. If you observe here, see, so this transaction module is completed, this guy, okay, a person. This payments module completed, this person, C. Then how it came to feature? Because they are working independently and they are committing the code into corresponding branches and they are raising the pull requests. So what your lead or technical lead will do, he will review the PRs, okay, and he will merge the code. Okay, so what is the concept here? Merge the code into future. So the same way, suppose you want to raise, okay, now we can see, now we can see in the develop branch whether that code is available. In the develop branch, this is develop branch. See here, this is develop branch. Observe carefully. See, we have only two files, hello and what. Hello and what. Now, I am going to raise a new pull request here. So what is the comparison branch now? Now it is future branch. I want to push my code into future to develop. That's very simple. See, future to develop. That's correct, right? Future to develop. I want to push my code. Then you can raise a PR here. You can raise a PR. Develop to future. Okay. This is a PR. Create pull request. See, here you can see what are the transactions. Okay. What are the commit operations we have performed. Okay. How many files are changed? How many contributors? See, there are two contributors. Okay. It's like, okay, it will show you all the statistics over here. But while raising the PR, you have to be careful which branch you are selecting. Which branch you are selecting. Okay. Which branch you are selecting. My base branch is now develop. My comparison branch is future one. So up to this part, user story A to future one is done. User story C to future one is done. Okay. There are two ways. One is by using git bash. He has done it. Next, he has done with it by using STS only. Okay, that's fine. Next, whatever it is, the code is there in a GitHub. Now, create pull request, select the branches and create the pull request. Okay, create the pull request. So here you can see there are only two files as of now, from future one to dev code merge. Okay, so if you want, you can assign with yourself, or here you can assign with the reviewer and create pull request. Okay, you can assume I am your reviewer. So what I will do, so I'll get a pop-up or message into my email box. Okay, it is showing like, okay, there is one PR is assigned with you, just review and merge the code. What I will do, I'll go to these commits. Okay, these many commits are happened from feature to develop branch. Okay, that's fine. The code, everything is good. Now I'll create a merge pull request, and here I will confirm the merge. See, after I confirming the merge, just observe here, I'll do refresh. See how easily these two files are added. So this is how we can add the files, guys. Okay, this is how we can add the file. So this is very, very important. This is very, very important. Even in interviews also, they will ask, okay, how you are cloning the code? What is the branching strategy? What is pull request? How you will pull and push the code and everything, okay? See, the same way, the person B also, he will take the code, he will create the branch on top of future one, and he will work on it. Once he's done with his work, he'll push the code to first user story B, and he will raise the PR. From here, your technical lead is going to take care, or project manager or team lead is going to take care. So sometimes if you want to take care, so you know the process now, okay, the end-to-end process, you know now what you need to do, okay? You can raise a PR and you can ask some person to review that code, and you can merge it with corresponding branches. So that's how we can do it. See, the second time we are not using any git bash. So just we are directly taking all the options from STS itself. But for that, you need to generate a token key, and your username you have to remember. You have to remember. Okay, fine. We are in at the end of the class. So the same way, once we have a two more regions like QA and production regions. Okay, these two are like lower environments, development QA. Okay, once it is done from feature to develop, right? Okay, feature to develop is done. The same way you can raise a PR, same way you can raise a PR, and you can merge the code into QA so that it will be deployed into all the applications into your QA region. So here, the testing. So there is a, some time they are going to assign, like there are 1 month or 2 months time. They are going to do testing here. So once the testing is done, once you get to sign up for testing team and UAT, okay, we are going to raise again the PR and we are deploying the code into production region so that in the production region, it will work your code. Suppose there are some defects or bugs in QA, what you need to do? Again, the same process. Suppose there is an issue with, payments module, what user C will do? He will push the code, sorry, he will clone the code from future C on top of future one. Future one user story C is going to do it. Okay, there is some issue. So he want to add one more logger here. So that is expected. Okay. This is end of the project. End of the GitHub session. Suppose something like this. Okay. This line he has added. So he's, there is only one line. Okay. One line or few lines he has added here. Okay. Then what is the next step? Again, there is an issue in develop region, development region or QA region. The corresponding developer will is going to take care of that issues. Okay. I'll talk about later. Okay. Where we are going to see that issues, okay, that it is in a Jira, okay, there is a separate tool, they are going to raise the defects, then you have to analyze and you have to pick, which module it is failing, okay, you can assume like, okay, there is a module it is failing with payment, suppose, so this is my latest code, always, I pulled it from already from feature branch. So my code changes also done. Then I'm going to push my code. Okay. I'm going to push my code into user story C. Again, here you can see, you can go to commit. You can go to team and commit. So it will display like this. Just click on plus plus. Here you can add like, okay, bug fix, commit and push. It is cool. 92 is my username. So what is the passcode? The passcode also you have to mention here. Just click on login. Close it here. So now, the code is present in which branch? User story C. You have to raise a pull request for feature one. That is very, very important. Just to go to code, compare and pull request from where to where? From user story C to, sorry, my base branch is future. What is the branch here? User story C. Okay, bug fix. Bug fix is done. Create pull request. Again, the same process. Merge pull request, confirm merge, okay. As soon as you merge the code, see bug fix. Okay, bug fix is present in now. It is in a feature branch. Again, from feature, to dev, see bug fix is done. Okay, So from feature to develop, we have to raise the PR again. I'm going to raise pull request. Click on pull request. You can raise a new pull request or you can click on compare and pull request. So that is also fine. So now what is the base branch here? Develop. Develop is my base branch. The comparison branch is future one. Okay, future one. Feature to dev bug fix. So this is your comments. Okay, this is your comments. You have to keep it. Create a pull request. While creating pull request, you have to select reviewers always. The reviewer will get a notification. He will review your code and he is going to merge your code. Merge your code. So the merge is done. See how quickly it is happened. Okay, just I'm going to refresh. Just observe here. Just observe. Click on this payments. See, the new line were added. The new line were added. You can able to see the committed commit also. The committed comment. Okay. That's it for today's class, guys. Okay. I'll share the recording with you. Just you can practice this one. Okay, you can practice this one. If you have any doubts, you can ping me in a WhatsApp or you can post something in a group. I'll happy to assist you. Yeah, thank you guys.